morning, children. All are fine now? Here, why two children are sitting in the middle row? That social distance is enough. Bag is there, but this side? This side, that distance is enough. You can just reach to this side. If you maintain the social distance, it will be well and good. For our sake only, we are keeping that one. Social distance and all. That side also, Rohit and Yashwan. Go to the end. Okay, children, did you note, did you watch yesterday's virtual classes about the trigonometry? No. Did not know about it or don't know how to? What is that?
We know that it is there, but we did not see it.
You can see that if you press that link, what we have given, it will be coming. Actually, I thought it was on Tuesday, today. I was thinking that one, it is on 15th, but it is not on 15th. It is 14th and 19th. No need of sending it. Who is asking that to send it? That link is there. I'll show you how to get it. I sent the link to you yesterday also to both the classes. Yeah, this is the link we are given. We need not attend the class when it is going on, when the live is going on. This is the link. Now in the link, if you press it, the 14th. This is the 14th link. 12th and 13th. That English scene 3. Act 2 or something like that, yeah, you want to check that also. Now if you press it, this is link, it will come. Yeah, data is not on, that is at home, I am using the Wi-Fi, no, that's. Ronald, you had called me for what, Ronald? Donald? Shivacharan also that class is there. Okay, understood now what to do? If you press it that link and I checked it also that 19th will come or not. I thought already they had recorded and they are giving it on that day and all. But when I press in that 19th link, it is not coming. They said after, it will be coming after 4 days. That means yesterday, today, Friday, today, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. After 4 days. That means it is not recorded. Yesterday they gave it as live, but it is coming as a recorded work also. It will be coming in the, not it is live. Live recorded one in the YouTube. Who is that? Okay, afterwards I will record. So in the first class, they had given about the introduction and all. First class, they had given about the introduction. Introduction means what all you had learned about the trigonometric ratios in the 9th class and the remaining part. The rules that, what is that called, square relations. Reciprocal relations, quotient relation, and also the definition of all the trigonometric ratios. Now, next, the second part I did not check it. They said that introduction and all will be given. Not coming here. Yeah, okay. It's coming, no Wi-Fi connection. Playback will use mobile data. That is on all. Anyway, you can check it at home, how to get it and all. Even that English work also, you can check it. English, what, Merchant of Venice only, I think, no? Merchant of Venice, which one? Act 3, Act 2. Act 3, I too don't know properly. Act 3, Scene 2, that you can see. Second one, I didn't check it. What is the 13th one also, 13th day also? Same one only, continuation.
First one only,
check. So what is that one? You have to get your sanitizer. Okay, you have bought it and you don't want to use it, you want to use from here. Teacher also had sent the message that one don't share anything. Anyway, of course he did not touch that one. He only gave you. But you use what you have brought it. Even pen, pencil or book or whatever it is, you don't share anything. Okay children, today we'll start the lesson, fifth lesson. I think 10th B already over, no? Full part is over?
Over.
Or only one exercise is over? Fifth lesson.
Teacher, 4C teacher.
Pardon?
4C.
4C I'll take you after this. They already completed. Fifth lesson already over? So we'll take it as a revision. You just attend the class as a revision. 10th A boys, listen to the class. Fifth lesson, refraction through a lens. In the last lesson, we learned about the refraction through the prism and different types also we learned it. That is in the glass prism as well as in the triangular prism also we learned that how the refraction will be taking place in the prism. In the last exercise, I did not teach for these children. Last exercise says that 4C says that about the critical angle and the total internal reflection. I'll just tell about it also then we can. Critical angle and total internal reflection. When the refraction takes place from the denser medium to rarer medium. We have learned about the rarer medium to denser medium and as well as the denser medium to rarer medium. The previous chapter we had learned denser medium to rarer medium so that the object will be little bit raised up. Apparent depth will be there, original depth will be there and shift also, that formula also we learned it. All of you remember that one? You have to learn every day's portion, that day itself, then only you can remember it. When you listen to that, you will be getting some 50%. After that, read it and go through all the points and only you will get another 50%. So in that chapter, we learned that exercise, we learned about the denser medium to rarer medium. When the light ray moves from the denser medium to rarer medium, what will happen to the refractor ray?
It bends away from the...
Refractor ray?
Bends away.
Towards the?
Away from
the normal. When it goes from the rarer medium to denser medium only, it will be moving towards the normal. When it moves from the denser medium to rarer medium, it will be moving away from the normal. What is the reason for that one?
Speed of the light.
Yeah. Difference in the speed of light in the different media. That is, in the denser medium, the speed of light is?
Less than.
And the rarer medium, this light is falling on my face. The rarer medium, as it was, like this only.
It's for what?
To get the reflection. Master, brother is there, eh? Tell him to move this light from here, no? Just keep the position. I don't know for what purpose he kept the light. Because of that, it is falling on my eyes and... Keep it this side somewhere. Can you keep it this side? Yeah, small. I know, no, don't keep it.
Then I will switch off the page.
Then better than keep it at the before position on it.
Brother?
I cannot see anyone. Be getting recorded. No, just to find out from where. Before position only nicer. Keep it like that only, Master. When brother comes, I will ask him. Keep it how it was. No, keep it how it was. Down, down. when it moves from the denser medium to rarer medium, the speed of light in denser medium is less than the speed of light in the rarer medium. Therefore, it will be moving away from the normal. That is, this will be called as the angle of incidence, and this is known as the angle of refraction. Now, when we take the angle of incidence little more than the previous case, what will happen? That is I1, this is I1, I2 is more than I1. What will happen? It will be bending more towards the surface, that is move away from the, who are those children? That given, Prithvi, completed all the record books? Given the letter also? And what about Sahu? Gave the books, get inside. This will be moving more away, listen here, let them go, you see, listen here. It will be moving more away from the normal. That is, R2 will be more than R1. R2 will be more than R1. Again, if we take another situation, that is, incident angle little more than the previous case, or I3 is more than R3. I3 is more than I2. Then we can see that R3 also is coming more than R2. R3 also is coming, that is angle of refraction also will be more than angle of, this is previous case, angle of refraction. Now, when we come to a certain angle, that is suppose this angle, I4, angle of incidence is equal to I4. Yashwant is not listening here, looking outside. Anybody said that they will come and call you? No, no? Then listen here. Otherwise, if it is means, you can go outside and stand there. I4 is more than I3, that is angle of incident in the fourth case is more than angle of incident in the third case. In this case, we may get that the angle of refraction is 90 degree, that is this will be the refractor rate. In the fourth case, not every time fourth case, I just say one example only. In the fourth case, for that some certain angle of incidence, we can see that angle of refraction is more, angle of refraction is equal to 90 degree, or refractor ray is on the surface, that is surface of the separation of the medium. Now, when it is more than, little more than this angle, that is I5 is more than I4, what will happen? What is the next movement of the refractor ray? To the same media, that is down. This refractor ray will be like this. What is this called as? The light ray is incident on one surface and coming back to the another same surface. What it is called as?
Reflecting.
It is called as the reflection. So in this case, that is certain angle. Angle is this angle is not. This is known as the total internal reflection. In other cases, some part of the light will be getting reflected. Very small quantity of light will be getting reflected and maxima will be getting refracted. When the reflection takes place also ordinary way, when we take the reflection on the plane mirror also, some part will be getting refracted and maximum part will be getting reflected. Is it clear? When we learned about in the plane mirror, reflection on the plane mirror also, not the 100% of light incident on the surface will be getting reflected. Some 5% will be refracting to the another media and only 95% will be getting reflected. Same way in the case of refraction also, some 5% will be getting reflected, that is coming back to the same media by obeying the loss of reflection. What is the loss of reflection?
Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection.
And incident ray, reflector ray, normal drawn at the point of incidence in the same light. So by obeying the loss of reflection, 5% in each case, 5% like that, it will be getting reflector. Maximum quantity will be getting refractor. Now in this case, that is in this particular angle, that is each case we consider. Here it is getting refractor, here also it is getting refracted, whatever it is, 95% or 96%, whatever it is. Third case also getting refracted, fourth case also got refractor. This also will be called as the refraction. Fifth case also refraction, but it is same as the reflection. In this condition, the full intensity of light will be getting reflected. that is 100% of light will be getting reflected, and this phenomena is known as the total internal reflection. The reflection on the plane mirror and reflection on this like this reflection, this will be better because it is 100% will be getting reflected. In the ordinary reflection on the plane mirror, only 95% or 98% only will be getting reflected. So this is having more intensity. That means it will be showing the nice picture, clear picture. And is it clear to fourth, this is the 10th year boys? So this is known as the total internal reflection, and this previous case angle of incident is known as the critical angle.
90 degrees.
That where we get the refraction as 90 degree angle or refraction along the surface of the separation. So that separation of the medium. So this angle at the angle of incidence at which the angle of refraction is 90 degree is known as the critical angle. And if the angle of incident is more than the critical angle for each surface, critical angle is the critical angle of glass is 42 degree. Like that, some points are given. You will get it for the some sorts. You will get it. Refractive index, critical angle of the glass is 42 degrees. Critical angle of water is 49 degrees. Some tables are given, not by hearting all the tables, but for the glass and water, we just learn it. Other one, if they give that one, they'll give the critical angle also. Most of the questions, most of the sums, they'll give the critical angle. In case if they have not given, that is mainly for the glass and water, you better learn it. So critical angle of glass is 42 degrees Celsius, 42 degree, and critical angle of water is 49 degree. So at this, in the glass, if the angle of incident is 42 degree, what will be the angle of refraction? In glass, angle of incident is 42 degrees. What is the angle of refraction?
90 degrees.
Angle of refraction is 90 degrees. In glass, if the angle of incident is 50 degrees, what will be taking place there? Total internal reflection will be taking place. That is, the ray will be getting reflected to the same area. Do you understand that one? And through the triangle and all the sums are there, points are there, I'll tell you afterwards. So like this, you'll get the question also. Diagram, different angle of incidence are given. They will be given the critical angle of the glass, 42 degree. Critical angle of the glass is 42 degree. Rays are moving from the glass to air, denser medium to rarer medium. Different angle of incident rays are given with different angles, and you should know what will be the correct refractive array. If it is less than 42 degree, it will be in the second medium. If it is equal to 42 degree, it will be
90.
On the surface, 90 degree. By the angle of incidence, this will be the angle of refraction, 90 degree. If it is more than 42 degree, total internal reflection. There also, they will be obeying the laws of reflection. That is, angle of incidence will be equal to angle of reflection. Did you understand about the total internal reflection? Okay, then other parts I will tell you afterwards. That is the deviation, total internal reflection in a prism. Different types of prism are there, 45, 45, 90 degree, and in that also, one can be used as to deviate a ray of light through 90 degree, and another one to deviate a light through 180 degree. Third one is to erect the inverted image without the deviation. That also all the three cases in the 45, 45, 90 degree, that is isosceles prism. And another one with us, equilateral triangle, to get the deviation not in the 90 and all, and where all we can use it, those points, examples, other, I'll tell you afterwards. Now come to this lesson, refraction of a through the lens. In the 9th class, you have learned about the spherical mirrors. All of you can remember those points? Spherical mirrors, concave mirror and the convex mirror. And the reflection, what is the concave mirror, what is the convex mirror?
Concave mirror means, it is concave, it is thin at the middle means, and thick at the periphery.
I am not asking about the lens, you are telling the answer of the lens. I asked, what is the concave mirror, spherical mirror? It will be bulged outside and the reflection will be taking place inside. reflection will be taking place inside, and the images all will be real except one case. That is, when will be the images virtual? Which position? Not remembering. If the object is kept between focus and the pole. If the object is kept between focus and the pole, we will get a virtual image. That is, behind the mirror, we will get spherical mirror, we will get the image. Other cases, all the cases, that is, if the object is at focus, we will get it in infinity. Object is between focus and center of curvature, we will get the real image. If it is at the center of curvature, there is one special point in that one. If the object is kept at the center of curvature,
image is at center of curvature.
Image size will be same.
And formed at center of curvature.
Pardon?
Formed at center.
Forming it also at the center of curvature. Image also will be forming at the center of curvature. And only thing, inverted image. That is, if the object is kept at the center of curvature. And in the case of the convex mirror, wherever we keep it, we will get the virtual image, erect, virtual, and the diminished images. In the concave lens, when we keep the concave mirror, when we keep the object between focus and pole, we will get the magnified image, big image magnified, but it will be virtual. But in the case of the convex mirror, wherever we keep the objects, the image will be virtual, size will be smaller than the size of the object at all. Now let us come to the point that what is a lens. Yes, as Lohit said, what is a lens, Lohit?
It's a transparent medium.
Transparent medium. What is meant by the transparent?
We can see it.
Light can pass through that one. What is the medium which is in which light cannot pass through at all? Okay. Little bit light is passing through is translucent. Okay, lens is a transparent refractive medium bounded by two curved surfaces which are generally spherical. That is, as we said, two parts of the surface, like this, one sphere here, equal one means both will be equal. These two parts, this is a part of one sphere, the curvature part of one sphere, and which is having the center of curvature, and which will be, we can find out the radius of curvature. This is another sphere, this one also is having the center of curvature. As we learn, the center of curvature of this part is same as the center of the sphere of which the spherical mirror is the part. Like that, here also we can be. Here two surfaces will be there, 1 and 2 we can name it. This is known as the convex lens. Here this is known as the convex lens. This is known as the convex lens. Whereas in the other one, this is the concave lens. If you remove this one, this part will be known as the concave lens. Understood? So this lens is a transparent, underline that point, all of you. Especially 10th year boys, 10th B boys might have underlined those things, you know. What is a lens? You can write the question there. What is a lens? Or just underline it, important like that you have to learn it. So here now, no need of reading. First time you have to read the full textbook. Yes, this you are Sandeep. Anything, any problem is there? Not having the pen or pencil like that, you are looking around to get it? No. Listen here. When you read it the first time, you have to read the full textbook. Second time when you read, so first time when you read the textbook, you may find out some important points. Like this blocks, in the block it will be given, or some points will be, this is the reason for this to happen. Like that, and when you see it, underline that part. You can frame the question also there. Always physics, you will get the questions from the textbook only. I mean theory part. Exercise is only one helping box. Some questions they are given. Some ready-made questions they are given. we may not get the questions from the exercise and all. Something related we may get it, but I am not telling that not to read it. That also you can read it, you may get it. But mostly you will get it from the theory part. So you have to read the textbook nicely. So after listening here, when you go home, read the textbook first time, full point you read it. Then underline which are coming important one. Now also I will be telling you that you can underline it. Then afterwards, second time when you read it, you have to give more concentration on the underlined part. Not enough reading the full part. Only the underlined part you have to give more concern. That read twice, thrice, like that you will get the points. So here also, said anything? That is another type. This is the main one. We will consider to do the sums and to do the array formation and we will use this type only. In this one, another two more types are there. That is, here two spherical mirrors, both are convex mirrors. Another one is plano convex mirror lens. One side plane and one side convex. Another one is concavo convex. Concavo convex. One is concave and one is convex mirrors. Like that. Same way here also you can find out. Plano concave. One side plane and one side concave. And convexo concave. One side convex, one side concave. Like that also you can get it. That is different types only. So underline this one. A lens is a transparent medium bounded by two curved surfaces which are generally spherical, which may be combination of the two convex mirrors or combination of two concave mirrors. Now there are two types of lenses. What are the two types of lenses? One is the convex lens, as we said. Another name of this convex lens is converging lens. Why it is called as a converging lens? When the light ray strikes on one surface, afterwards when we do the sun center, only thin mirror will use it. Thin mirror means we may not show the deviation taking place in the lens inside the glass. Understood? Now I will just show you. This is from the air to glass. So what will happen to air to glass when it moves? There will be a deviation from the incident ray. This is the refraction taking place inside the mirror. Just like what we learned in the refraction in the prism also. Here it is a glass mirrors. Combination of the mirrors, that's only the difference. And how we can connect this one with the help of the prism also, I will tell you. Now this is the from air to glass. So there will be a deviation. This line ray will be moving
away from now.
Towards the mirror. You have to remember that point. Why? Because the speed of light in air is more than speed of light in glass. Or speed of light in glass is less than. Less means speed is less means what will happen? Movement will be slow. When the speed is less, movement will be slow. So because of that slow movement only, the refraction is taking place. Understood that one? Not refraction. Refraction is taking place because of the difference in the speed of light. And because of the less speed of light, it will be moving towards the normal. That is when the rarer medium to denser medium. Now this refractor ray is striking the second surface of the lens. This is the, which medium is this one?
Denser.
Listen here all of you children. Denser. And it is going to the rarer medium. What will happen? Away from the normal. Because here the speed of light is more. Those who did not attend the, this one we did not take. The other class also. Prism lesson also, they don't know what is going on here. Those who did not attend the prism class. I am talking about the 10th year boys. 10th B anyway teacher took the lesson. There also they did not attend means they cannot know. So when it moves from the rarer, denser medium to rarer medium, it will be moving like this. This is the refraction taking place. Is it clear? So here in this case, it will be moving this way. When we consider another incident ray, here also it will be moving like this first, then converging. All the parallel rays, this is the parallel to the principal axis. Here also there will be the principal axis. Parallel to the principal axis, after refraction, it is passing through one particular point. As we learn in the spherical mirror also, this particular point will be called as the focus. Focus. Foci. Two focus, foci will be there. Because? Why two foci are there? Two mirrors are there. Two spheres. Connection of two spheres. So two spheres means there will be two center of curvatures, two foci and two focal length, two focal plane. All those will be there in the case of the concave mirror also, concave lens also. So first one is convex lens, which is also called as the converging. Converging because after refraction, the parallel rays of light will be meeting through the point, passing through the point. Whereas here we can see it is getting diverged. When we produce this refractor ray backward, we can see that it is passing. There is one more ray only, we can clear it. Passing through the particular point. That is, which is called the diverging. The ray will be, refractor ray will be moving like this. In the prism lesson also you have learned it. Refractor ray will be moving towards the, towards the base of the prism. If we consider here three parts, lower part and upper part are in the shape of the prism. A thin lens means it will be very like that, it is almost looking like a triangle prism only. And the middle part is like the glass. So in the glass it is going without any deviation. From the topper part it is moving towards the base. Upper, top part, lower part it is moving towards the base, it will be meeting at one point. Here also if you consider as a 2-3 prism part. Upper part having the base on top, lower part the base is having down. So upper part what will happen to this refractor ray? It will be moving towards the base. Lower part is moving towards the base. And when we produce it backwards, we get this point. Here in the center, it is moving without any deviation because it is considered as the glass prism. Okay, we come to the point that. So convex lens is known as the diverging lens. And what is the convex lens is given here? It is thicker in the middle. Thicker in size in the middle. Thinner. Here to show you only I have drawn like this. Actually it will be very narrow. Very narrow one. Like this it will be. Now this much thick also won't be the lens what we are using for the ray formation at all. Thicker in the middle and thinner its periphery. Other words, lens which bulges out. Bulges out in the center. That is known as the convex lens or the converging lens. Light beam converges on passing through a convex lens, so it is called as the converging lens. There you may get the question. One lens is given. What is the name of this lens? Whether it is converging or diverging? Why? Why it is called as converging? Clearly you can get one. Another paragraph is given there, I will tell you. Why it is called converging? Because the parallel rays of light will be passing through a point. That is why it is called as the converging. Other one, parallel rays of light will be moving away from one point. Appear to be moving away from one point. That is why it is known as the diverging. And in this convex lens, there are three types. One is biconvex. Biconvex means both the sides are convex. Or double convex or equiconvex. Equiconvex means both are equal. That means that both the radii will be equal. Both the spheres are equal, both the radii will be equal. Then another one is plano convex. One side is, keep it there properly, tie it and leave it. It is distracting you. Very tight means keep it proper way. Plano convex means one side is plane and another side is a convex. Like this it will be. Plano convex. One side is a plane mirror, another side is convex mirror. And concave convex. One side you can see the concave and another side you can see the convex. That is the concave convex. All these details are given here. Bioconvex, both the surfaces are convex. Plano convex, one surface is plane, other surface is convex. You can underline those points, children. While the concave convex lens has one surface convex and the other surface concave. Now next one is concave lens. Periphery means center, end points. This side. tip and end of the mirror there. Top end, not only down, top and down part of that one. That is known as the pendulum. Here also you can see the concave mirror is called as a diverging lens. Concave lens, not mirror. Concave lens is thicker in the periphery. Thicker in the periphery, thinner in the middle. That is one of the differences between convex lens and the concave lens. Convex lens, thicker in the middle, thinner in the periphery. Slip was not enough, I think, Srinivas. And here, thicker in the periphery and thinner in the middle. Getting sleep? No. Which is bent inwards. It will be bent inwards. The other one is bulged outwards. The concave lens is bent inwards. And it will be diverging the light rays incident on it, so it is called as the diverging lens. And here also you can see three types. One is biconcave, both the sides are concave, or it will be called as a double concave, two concave mirrors. EQ concave, both are equal, means it will be called as that both are having the equal radii of curvature, it will be called as the equal concave. And one is plano concave, one side plane and another side concave. One side convex or concave, one side convex and other side is concave. Here the difference between the difference and similarity. What is the difference and similarity of the concave or convex lens and convex or concave lens? Can you say the difference and can you say the similarity? It is given in that note. You can underline that point. Both the concave or convex and convex or concave lenses have one surface convex and the other surface concave. That you can say as the similarity. Both are similar in this way. In both the cases, one face is convex and another face is concave. What is the difference? In their shapes and action. In their shape and action. What is in the shape? The middle concave or convex lens is thicker in the middle and has a converging action. Are you underlined that? Thicker in the middle and having the converging action in the case of the concave or convex. That is mostly it will be acting the concave lens properties. While the convex or concave lens thinner in the middle and has a diverging action. These two are the differences between the concave or convex and convex or concave mirrors. Now the refraction through the light, already I told you. Action of the lens as the prism, also I told you, just read those parts. And let us go to the technical terms related to the lens. The other parts already said when I was discussing the points. What are the technical terms related to the lens? First one is center of curvature. What is meant by the center of curvature? The center of the sphere whose part is the lens surface. The center of the sphere whose part is the lens surface is called the center of curvature. I told you, if you consider two spheres here, this first surface is the part of the sphere and this sphere will be having the center. So this center is known as the center of curvature of the first surface. This is the second surface, which is the part of the sphere, which that also is having another center of curvature. Center, here it is known as center. Center of the sphere. The other one is center of curvature. Why it is known as center of curvature? Because only the curved part we are considering. Only the curved part. Here actually only this curved part we are considering. This is the part of the sphere. So what is the center of curvature of the second surface here? Center of the sphere. There we should not say the center of the center of curvature of the sphere. Are you getting the point? In the sphere, when we say, when we discuss about the center of the sphere, we should not say center of curvature of the sphere. When we say the center of curvature, that is center of that spherical mirror part, we have to say the center of curvature, because only that curved part we are considering. That is why it is known as the curvature. That part is known as the curvature. This part will be known as the curvature. Curved part of the sphere only we are taking. That is why it is called as the center of curvature. Are you getting it? So center of curvature of the lens is the center of sphere of which the mirrors, the surfaces are the part of it. Did you get that point? Underline that also. Center of the sphere whose part is a lens surface is called the center of curvature of that surface. Here two surfaces are there, therefore two centers will be there. For the first surface, as is given in the text diagram, first surface, right hand side, you can see the center. First surface is this one, and this right hand side one is known as the center of curvature of the first surface. For the second surface is the part of the left hand side sphere, therefore this left hand side sphere center is known as the center of curvature of the second surface of the lens. Got it? Same way in the case of the concave mirror, concave lens. Concave lens, if we take this one as the first part, this side is the first part and this one is the second surface. This first surface is the first curvature is the part of the sphere. The sphere is having the center. So center of the sphere C1, which is the center of curvature of the first surface. And the second curvature or the second surface of the lens is the part of the sphere, and the center of the sphere, it will be marked as C2, which is called as the center of curvature. They don't say only center, center of curvature of the surface. So here for the second part we can see the center of curvature on right hand side, and for the first surface we can see the center of curvature on the left hand side. Whereas in this first surface we can see the center of curvature on the right hand side, and second surface we can see the center of curvature on the left hand side, because that sphere is on left hand side. Second curvature surface, the sphere is on the remaining part of the sphere is on left hand side. That is why here C2 will be here, C1 will be here. The diagram also you have to remember about it. For convex lens, C1 is to the right side, that is given here. Convex lens, C1 is to right surface of right side of the surface 1, and C2 is the left surface, left side of the surface 2. While for a concave lens, C1 is the left side of the surface 1, and C2, underline it. C2 is the right side of the surface 2. Now radius of curvature. Radius of the sphere whose part is the lens surface. What is the radius of the sphere? Radius of the sphere, actually we can connect it from this point. From here till center. This is known as the radius of the sphere. That will be the radius of curvature. Radius of curvature, that is if you mark a point here P1. P1, C1 will be the radius of curvature of the first surface. And same way P1, C2 will be the radius of curvature of the second surface. Now when we consider the thin lenses, everywhere for, I told you already, ray diagrams channel will be using the thin surfaces. Thin surfaces mean this much thick won't be there, only very narrow it will be there. So this point as well as the middle point also will be same, almost the same in length. Only one decimal part will be the different center. So almost same we can take it. And that point is known as the optical center. So the radius of curvature will be same as if you mark that optical center as it is exactly middle of this line. Optical center, almost this P1 and this point will be same. P1 is the point on the sphere we have taken, like this here. And almost for the thin lens, P1 and O will be almost the same position. Only to make it clear about it, only we have drawn like this. So P1, C1 will be same as O, C1, and P1, C2 will be same as O, C2. So P1, C1 or O, C1 will be the radius of curvature of the first surface, what is on the left hand side of the lens, and P1, C2 or O, C2 will be the radius of curvature of the second surface, that is on the right hand side of the lens. Now what is meant by the principal axis? In the mirror also we have learned the principal axis. What is the principal axis in the mirror? The line joining the pole and the center of curvature. Here we can say the definition, right? The line joining the centers of both the spheres or centers of both the curvatures. the line joining the centers of both the spheres or the line joining the centers of both the curvatures, that is C1, C2 will be the principal axis.
And for OC2 and BC2 or C1,
that is, I told you, this is a thicker lens. We will be considering very thinner one. So almost there won't be this much also cannot. Almost, less than this size also. Almost less than. So this point and the actually optical center will be coming on this line. This point and this point will be almost the same. Actually from here to center of curvature on, we are taking the radius. From this point to center of curvature. In the case of the thinner mirror, O is optical center, and that end this P1 point will be almost the same. No difference, not much difference will be, very small fraction. That is why we can take it as OC1 or P1C1 will be equal. In this case, to make it to clearly to understand that point only, we are considering like this, that a little thicker one end. And this, those cases not enough showing. When we draw the ray diagram, and not enough showing like this. Directly, this ray will be moving till middle. From here, only one refraction. Because we are considering this part is very small, very thin. That is why no difference, no refraction taking place inside the glass, won't be seeing it, showing it. This is only to clear you the points and all, we are just drawing the thicker. Optical center, already I told you, the point on the principal axis. Not brought the textbook, Srinivas? Brought it. Marking the points also. I can see you moving there, looking this side and that side. Anything distracting you? No, no. Listen here properly. All of you. Some of you did not attend the online classes, so don't know what is the refraction, what is meant by the refraction and all. Reflection, of course, you know, because we learn in 9th standard, in the physical class only. But the online classes, those who did not attend the classes, don't know what is this refraction, what is this reflection, one word. That's all they will know. Now, Prithvi? Now understanding the points, very good. What about Rohit? They are not, never used to attend the classes and all. Huh? Once in a while. Rohit? Once in a while. Full moon day, new moon day, like that they will come. Attendance also less, I think. I will tell you the attendance. You have to meet father with your parents. I'll tell you the attendance. I already sent a message and all. Okay, we come to the point that optical center is a point on the principal axis of the lens such that ray of light passing through this point emerges parallel to the direction of the incident ray. Parallel to the direction of incident ray. That is, there will be some deviation from here if you... This is the incident ray. And it will be getting refracted like this. This ray will be parallel. To show the board. It's not coming yet. Clearly you can look at from the textbook. Page number, in this 116. Under the one optical center it is given. Under optical center it is given. The diagram. And see that, look at the thin one, thin mirror, for thin convex lens and concave lens in figure 5-10. So the optical center of a thin lens is the point on the principal axis of the lens through which a ray of light passes undeviated. In the case of the thin one, in the case of the thick lenses, the refractor ray will be parallel to the direction of incident ray. Now the last next part is about the principal foci.